Northern Lakes Hockey Association, Nate Prosser here. Thanks for having me. I'll be a part of your banquet. I'm super excited to be able to talk here for a little bit. Hopefully you guys made a lot of good memories this year, and you built a lot of strong friendships and strong bonds on your teams. And I'll go through some of the questions you guys asked me. I'm excited to answer them. And excited to be a part of your night, and hopefully you guys had a great year this year. So the first question is, when did you start playing hockey and where did you play as a kid? I started playing about as soon as I could walk. My dad and my brother both played, and they kind of forced me into playing. My brother was 3 years older than me. We grew up in Elk River, Minnesota, so not far from you guys. I remember sitting in all these banquets and going through all these seasons just like you guys did. I'm one of you guys. Elk River was a great, great town to grow up in, really centered around hockey. All on my street, everyone played hockey. In the summers, we played street hockey. In the winters, we were out on the outdoor rinks, and just really rink rats. We'd build Stanley Cups out of tin foil and play for those, and get our music out next to the street when we're playing street hockey. And just a lot of great memories growing up in Elk River. It was a good small town, good feel. In high school, the city kind of shut down, and we'd get good crowds at our hockey games, and we had some good teams. I remember going to the state tournament my sophomore year, going down the XL. Just memories for days. But along those lines, there was times where I made the B teams. I think I made the B squirts, B peewees. You know, again, I didn't make any of the good AAA teams. I didn't make the Blades. I didn't make the select 15, 16, or 17 teams. And all along the way, people kind of told me that you aren't fast enough. You don't have a good enough shot. You're not quick enough. And I use that as fire. The reason I made it to the level I did was my work ethic and my attitude. And I brought that each and every day. And I made sure when people told me those things and I got cut from these teams, I worked harder. I went out to the track and did plyometrics and sprints by myself. I got to work in at the weight room. I shot more pucks because, you know, to get a harder shot, you need to work at it. It's not just going to come naturally. There's a lot of things in hockey that you got to push yourself. And what kind of character do you have? Well, do you push yourself, or do you need your dad or someone to tell you to go do these things? And for me, I looked on the inside and I said, well, I want to be better. I want to get a college scholarship. I, you know, want to play in the NHL someday. Those are my goals. And in order for me to get those things, I needed to have that kind of work ethic and that attitude. I loved hockey. I loved going to the rink every day. I brought a smile on my face every day. So that was a long answer, but grew up in Elk River. I'll go to the next question. What are your favorite memories of being in the NHL? Well, definitely the Hockey Day in Minnesota in 2014. That kind of pops in my head right from the get-go. It was in my hometown of Elk River, down in the Hanky Pit. Kind of just a dreamy, beautiful setting. They did it right, Elk River did. And I played Dallas that night and got a shift in overtime, which I never did. I was always on the third set behind Ryan Suter and Jared Spurgeon and Dumba and Broads. And so I almost started, you know, taking my equipment off in overtime. But for some reason, my D coach said, Pross, you're up. And, you know, I had to kind of look back to make sure he wasn't messing with me. But, you know, I got on the ice and puck bounced out to me, put it 5-hole. That was a special night for me. And, you know, my first NHL game up in Edmonton, that'll always kind of be in my mind, and one I'll tell my kids, my grandkids about. Just the whole opportunity for me to get into the NHL, and that my dreams kind of came to life that night. Three defensemen got hurt, so kind of a whirlwind to make that opportunity come. And I got an assist and I was plus that game. So I was able to get on the management's radar from that game going forward. Next question. There's a lot more memories there, but I'll keep moving on. What do you do for fun on your free time? For fun, I like golfing. I like my time with my kids. I got four daughters. It's probably why I'm bald and you guys are staring at my bald head. But I got a 9-year-old, 8-year-old, 5-year-old, and a 2-year-old, all girls. So I like spending time with them. And I don't got much time to myself anymore. So it's all about giving my time to them. What did you do before you played professional hockey? Before I played, well, I played all my youth in Elk River, went to Sioux Falls, played for the Stampede, went to Colorado College for 4 years. I really enjoyed all my youth. I played baseball, and football. So I tell a lot of kids these days, like, I like the multi-sport athlete. So when the hockey season was over and the weather started getting nice, I love getting the bat out and the glove. And then once the weather started turning again in the fall, I liked tackling people. So I loved the idea of football. And then the snow came and it's like, okay, now I feel rejuvenated to get back into the hockey season. And I love just the multi-sport. And I think that helped me just be an athlete, just with working different muscles and working different parts of your brain, just rather than just playing hockey year round. I get that. Eventually, you need to come to that if you want to make a career of it. But I enjoyed all sports. Who's your favorite hockey player of all time? Favorite hockey player has to be Chris Pronger. I'll keep it short and sweet. He just kind of did everything. Power play, penalty kill, played a ton of minutes, was always led his team into the playoffs. But even more than that, I was able to watch two guys growing up in Elk River, Paul Martin, Dan Hynote. The guys that unbelievable, humble, kind guys that I was able to kind of look up to in those sense to build my character and help me be a good character guy in the locker rooms. And because that's all that matters at the end of the hockey's going to come and go for everybody. And I knew above all else, I wanted to build strong friendships and relationships. And that's what I'll remember the most of all my playing days. I played with thousands of players and the only thing that really matters is the type of person you are. What kind of guy are you to the trainers, to your coaches? Are you coachable? Are you bringing a good attitude and a smile on your face each and every day? Because really, that's all that's going to matter once hockey's done and it's over, and it's going to be for everybody. What kind of teammate are you going to be from guys looking back on you? What advice do you wish you would have gotten while you were in the NHL? I mean, my dad gave me good advice. So you gotta be able to flip a switch. Flip the switch when you get on the ice, turn into a mean, tough. He'd always say SOB, play with some gravel in your shorts, play hard, play physical, play mean. And then once you get off that ice, you flip the switch back and you turn into the nice guy that gets his homework done on time, calls his grandma and tells him that you love him. You're good with your brothers and sisters. You're keeping your room clean. Just all the stuff that makes a good kid a good kid. And so be able to flip the switch on and off. And once you get on that ice, it's go time. Play hard. Play freaking hard. Don't cross any line to, do anything stupid where you're checking guys from behind or using your stick the way it's not intended. But play hard, flip the switch back when you get those skates off the ice and, be that good teammate, be that good brother, be that good son. Thanks for having me, guys. Great questions. Hope you guys all have a great night. Talk soon. Bye.